Hello guys, this is Nilesh Kamre, and in this video we are going to troubleshoot issue related to feature update to Windows 10 version 1903, and the error code is 0x80070005. So in this video we are going to use 6 methods to troubleshoot this particular issue. So stay with me till the end of the video and I will show you how to resolve this issue with these simple methods. Before going ahead, I would like to request you to please hit the like button, hit the subscribe and press the bell icon to enable notifications for future videos. So let's go ahead and start the troubleshooting. I am going to show you 6 methods, and if any of the method works for you, please do comment the method name in the comment box so that I get the acknowledgement from your end that this video is helpful for you guys and will help me to create more videos on these kind of topics. So whenever we are trying to update Windows 10 to latest version, we have to keep lots of things into consideration if any application is going to support this new version or not. If my hardware is compatible with this new version, and hence we should check the compatibility of this version on test machine which is having all the applications installed on it. But a testing machine is a suggestion for people working in IT and have test computers, and not for the people using personal laptops and desktops. So the people having personal computers can follow the methods whichever I am going to show you in this particular video, and it will helpful for IT guys as well. So you have to follow all the methods one by one and how to check if issue is resolved or not. If the issue is not resolving, then you have to follow another method in this particular video. So the first method or suggestion I would say is to disable all the antivirus programs, whether it is Windows Defender or any third party antivirus program. Disable them or stop the service before updating to Windows 10 1903, because these programs interrupt the installation process of Windows updates and throws errors. It sometimes happens, sometimes does not. And to enable or disable Windows Defender, you can watch the video given in the I button. So I'm not going to show you this method, you have to watch that particular video and you would be able to disable Windows Defender by watching that particular video. So the next method is pretty much simple. Just type services.msc in the search box and then open it as run as administrator. Select any of the service and then press WIN on your keyboard and it will take you to services which is starting from W. Search for Windows update service, and this is the Windows update service and it is currently not started, it is stopped. So what I'm going to do is start the service from here. Now it is in the running state. If your service is started and still you are facing the issue, you have to just right click on it and then stop it and then again start it. Or you can do one thing, you can right click on it, you can go to properties, click on the properties and then stop and then start it. So in this way you can check if Windows restarting Windows update service is resolving your issue or not. If the issue is resolved, then it's okay, you can skip the methods. If issue is not resolved, then you have to follow another methods. Now you have to follow another method, and this particular method needs administrator rights and you must log into admin account to follow these steps. So type cmd in the search box and then open it as run as administrator. It will ask you for user account control permissions and then click on yes. Now it is open with run as now it is open with administrator rights, and now we can do administrative task on this command prompt. We have to rename the folder which is responsible for downloading Windows updates and then distribute it to your computer. And to do this, we have to first of all stop the service which is Windows Update Service. And to stop the service, just type net space stop, WUAUSERV is a command to stop. So net space stop space WUAUSERV is a command to stop the service, to stop the Windows Update Service. Now Windows Update services stop, and now we have to rename software distribution folder. And to rename software distribution folder, which is located in Windows folder C:\Windows folder path, I'm going to navigate to Windows folder and then type run is a command to rename the folder. Just type soft, press tab key, and it will complete software distribution space soft space dot bak. So I'm going to rename this folder to software distribution dot bak. Hit enter, and now the folder is renamed to software distribution dot bak. Just check out if the software distribution folder is renamed. You can see software distribution folder is renamed. Now we can start the service. Net space start space WUAUSERV is a command to stop the start the service. Hit enter, and the service is started. New folder is created. Now it will start downloading the new updates from Windows Update site, and then it will distribute and it will start the installation. So you have to check if this particular method is working for you or not. If this method is working, you don't have to follow another method. You just skip next methods. But I would request you to please stay with me to watch all the methods and to troubleshoot this particular issue. If the previous methods are not working, we have to check if any corrupt files are there or not, and to check the corrupt files and to fix them, and we have to use the command which is I'm going to show you. Just type cmd in the search box. You have to log in with administrator account and open the command prompt with administrator rights to run this particular command. So it will ask you for user account control permissions. Click on yes. Once this is open, just type sfc space slash scan now, and it will check if any corruption is there, corrupt files are there, and it will try to fix those particular files. It will take around 10 to 15 minutes, and you don't have to pause this verification and don't interrupt this process, so that it will check files and it will fix for you guys. So just follow this process and let this process complete, and then check if your issue is resolved or not. If issue is still not resolved, you have to follow another method that I am going to show you. So if last method, that is sfc scan now method, does not works, we have to follow another method, and that is we have to open the command prompt with the administrative privileges first to follow the next method. So I'm going to open the command prompt. Just click on the search box and then open the command prompt with administrative rights. So type cmd in the search box and then right click on the command prompt and then click on the run as administrator. It will open the command prompt with administrative privileges, and then type the command what I'm going to give you in this video. Once you open the command prompt with the administrative rights, you have to type the command that is I'm going to show you in this video, and then you have to type this command and then press enter. So dism space slash online space slash cleanup hyphen image space restore health. So this is the command you have to copy and paste on your Windows 10 machine. If you want to copy this command, just check out the description below, and then you can open the link and then copy the command from that particular website. So this is my blog, and you can copy this command from my blog and paste it into your Windows 10 computer to run this command. So just hit enter, and then it will start. So this tool is going to check if any system files are corrupt or not. If corruption is there, it is going to replace those particular files with the newer ones, and it will improve the health of your Windows 10 computer. It's going to take some time, like of 10 to 15 minutes, and meanwhile I'm going to pause the recording and we'll come back once this step is finished, and we'll check if the issue is resolved or not. You have to check if issue is resolved or not. If the issue is not resolved, we have to follow another method that I am going to show you in the next step. So if last method is not working, this method is pretty much easy to follow, and you have to do some mouse clicks and use, and your issue could be resolved. So right click on Windows, then click on the settings, click on the update and security, click on the troubleshoot, scroll down, and then click on the Windows updates and run the troubleshooter. So it will check if any issues are there with Windows updates, and it will try to troubleshoot the issue automatically. Once the Windows update troubleshooter finishes, and if it does not resolve the issue, we have to follow another step, and that particular step is just right click on Windows and then go to settings, click on the accounts, then click on the family and other users, click on the plus sign nearby, add someone else to this PC, and we are going to create a new user account with the administrative rights. So let's create a new local user which have administrative rights, and we will log in with that particular account and check if your Windows updates issue is resolved or not. I'm not going to use any email address or phone number, so I'll decide and I will click on I don't have this person's sign-in information, and then click on add a user without a Microsoft account. Create a local user, give a password, fill the information, and then click on next. Select the account and then click on change account type, and we will see what are all the options given over there. So there are options like standard user and administrator. I'm going to select administrator and then click on OK, and then we will log in with this account admini. I'm going to switch user, or else you can log off or restart the machine and then log in with this particular account and check if you are able to update Windows updates and you are not getting the error. So you have to log in with this account and then check in the settings by clicking on Windows updates, check for new updates, and check if you're able to download the updates from there. So that's it for this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button, please hit the subscribe, and press the bell icon to enable notifications for future videos. Thanks and bye bye.